Okay. It's Friday. And I'm all decked out in here with the microphones and in my miniature studio here, which is doing fine. There we go. Make sure my little arrow is in there. One we have my screen over here. And you can see live what's going on in my little studio. This is the main control board. Hit function F. There we go. Now we have everything showing. Well, it's been a crazy week. Elon Musk has created quite a stir with him buying, or he's under definitive agreement, subject to regulatory approval and all that kind of stuff, and so. We'll see what goes there. I have to file a couple of forms. A 10D for sure. In case you were interested. That is my the medicine piece, all the prescribed stuff that I take every day, and my hero machine, starts screaming at 7 o'clock telling me they're ready. So speaking of Elon Musk, yeah, I sent him a tweet. Of course, he probably gets a million tweets a day. So how would he see mine? I don't know, unless he's got three guys assigned in the home office to, you know, see what's going on, you know, to review his tweets. And if it stimulates something in their eyes, they'll raise it up to him. Anyway, I sent him like four tweets. And it all had to do with this in the hub. You know, like you had these electric bikes. I have two. And in the back wheel is a 350 watt hub motor. Which, you know, propels me with the twist of this hand right here on this side. So, you know, when you're riding a bike, so it has pedals and, you know, they're nice bikes. Nice heavy duty bikes, you know, made by Velec. V, like Victor. VELEC. you can go online and look up Velik. And it's actually a Canadian company that makes these bikes. And they, yeah, I mean, several, you know, 100,000 of them or something. But they're real heavy duty. They got a real good battery system that where you can pull the battery out. You know, which is a bunch of lithium cells, I believe. And that's like a 48 ampere hour battery, I think. No, 17 ampere hour battery. Up from the 13 ampere hour. So it's a 17 ampere hour. But it has a hub motor, you know, similar design to this one. Oops. Yeah, that one right there. And you can see the electronics. Yeah, right here. You know, they would be like 100 horsepower, 125 horsepower engines in each wheel. You got four wheels. And, you know, that should be the drive system in Tesla's electric cars, you know, to have one motor. You know, then with two shafts, you know, that's kind of quirky, but you know, I think this is the way to go for the future. So maybe a couple years from now, they may try those. Four motors, one in each wheel, up in the hub. And you still take your wheels off in the same method. Yeah, this is see, it still has the same 1, 2, 3, 5, you know, bolts, lugs that tighten the wheel onto the hub motor. What the heck? They should do it. So you got the hub motor, you have a speed reducer, you know, like a 10 to 1, because the motor's spinning at 5,000 RPM, you got to convert that to 500 RPM, and then you have, some kind of a, must be some kind of a clutch mechanism. I haven't heard much about how they, yeah, so I have I have my settings so this is it's in the no creep mode. So when you when you stop with a red light, and if you lift your pedal off the brake, the car doesn't automatically creep forward. You know, it doesn't like start rolling forward even before you touch the accelerator. I don't have that. I have no creep. So when the car, when I come to a full stop, which could happen with the regenerative braking, I don't even need to touch the brake pedal. But when I'm sitting at a red light, I put my foot on the brake pedal. (Coughs) to make sure, the car doesn't move forward by some quirk of the software. And all of a sudden I bang into the guy in front of me. Oops. Sorry, Tesla had a hiccup. No, I don't wait for that contingency. Anyway, so where is that? There you go. That's a nice note to self. I need these. Note to self. When things feel overwhelming, remember, one thought at a time, one task at a time, and one day at a time, please. Good advice. One thought at a time, one task at a time. Don't do too many things at once. I usually multi-process, but it's okay, it's a nice idea. See, now here's an example. A studio example of a hub motor. Yeah. And he's getting ready to put the screw to screw in there to keep it on. And then he's got the wheel over here behind him. Yeah. So that's what to do. Have four of those. This will work. But we'll try it. Oh, see, there it is. It seems to be working. This is a video. You can't hear it. There's another building being built there that allows for front view. That's big time. Let's see a little piece of this golf course right here. I think we're basically tight. Because of the way the plot is, let's say the building. So if the new building, the corner of it, is right where that truck is, it's going to come right up in here. I may see half the hotel, at best. Yeah, it depends on how that building is oriented. I was trying to get I asked a few people to get me the site plan. I mean, I guess I could go on the website, the city of Boca Raton on the website, and plug in Alina, which is the name of the condo development. There. You know, $1.5 million condos and up to like $4.5 million to $4.5 million. In case you happen to win the lottery or something, at least $4.5 million. This is the latest screen on. This is the software versions. If you have full service driving connected, optioned in the car, and I don't. As much as I am a Elon Musk fan, they call the full service driving program, you know, a beta program where you can test it, you use beta. beta baloney. It's alpha. And they, in my opinion, they shouldn't be releasing it to the public. You got like 30,000, people driving around on this software, it's too aggressive and it doesn't work. I don't like it. Now with your, on I-95 heading north, you put that sucker on autopilot, and it'll keep you in the lanes and everything's fine. Now with the full self-assist driving, keep you in the lanes, and then you can use your turn signal and the car will automatically move over, let's say to the left, to a faster lane of traffic, and it'll look out for other cars to make sure you can make that lane change without crushing somebody. So it does lane changes and all that on major highways, divided highways with well marked dotted lines. Most of the state highways are pretty good about all the line markers and stuff like that. So it's fine for that. I just asked a friend of mine, a family member, lives up in Virginia. She goes back and forth to North Carolina and Virginia. And married to my former son-in-law, JP, John Paul. Good man. Best son-in-law you could ever have. But unfortunately, my daughter basically adios them. Now my daughter has a new husband. Not so new, but 10 years ago or something, or 5 years, I figure what years. And he's a very liberal Democrat. And we just don't have anything in common to talk about. Even though he's married to my daughter, who is very bright and ambitious and all this stuff. When I go see her, we can't. We're yakking away, until all hours of the night, every night. When we go to dinner, we don't have much to talk about. Employee appreciation day. There we go. That's for Bert Rappaport. For Max's Grill, Bert and Max's, Deck 84. And the Pagoda Kitchen, whatever that, I'm trying to think of where that is. They'll be closed all day on May 3rd, Tuesday, which hasn't happened yet. So there are these little notices sent out to everybody, all the employees, and hanging on their doors apparently, because they're going to be closed. And the employees will be able to enjoy lunch and dinner I don't know where they're all. I guess they're going to have this in each store, because that doesn't say. They'll actually be closed. They'll be closed to the public. But the restaurants will be open to the employees and closed to the public. Each of these four. Good idea, Bert. Or whoever. There's an old Coke bottle. And notice it has a handle up here. You know, like grab it with your index finger or something. So with the jug, let's see if I can tell what size this container is. Okay, so Coca-Cola, delicious, refreshing, as you can see. And then right underneath Coca-Cola, right in the middle, it says to dispense. One ounce of Coca-Cola in 7 ounce glass of soda water. And you, 1 ounce of the syrup. And apparently in a stream of soda water, you pour the soda water onto the spoon, you know, to thoroughly get all the syrup off the spoon, and then you can use the, you know, the spoon to gently stir the soda water with the syrup so as not to decarbonate the carbonation. And there you go. That's what you would have. And this, can't see the copyright or what the date of this is. I'm sure I could, I'd have to go online and find out where this, you know, who took this picture. And see, or go onto the Coca-Cola site and see what they're, I enhance this picture a little bit so it's nice and clear, and it's a black and white, so I made it black and white instead of, you know, beige and white like an old picture. But that's pretty cool, isn't it? Jug of Coke syrup, just 1 ounce of 1 ounce of 1 ounce of Coca-Cola and 7 ounces of soda water. That's the concentration. No, here's a this little wire set. It's in the trunk of your Model Y or Model 3 or Model X, whichever model Tesla car you buy. But as of April 15th, maybe the 13th, I forget, something teeth, as of mid-April, no more. They're not including those in the trunk of the car anymore. Well, this is a $500 wire set. You know, the cable is as, you know, thick as your average thumb, with my gloves on. That's about the thickness of this cable. And, whoopsie. So from this thing, this is what plugs into the car. This is a 20-foot coil or cable connected to this doodad, which is some kind of a controller that controls the power that comes through, you know, when it's actually running. You plug this into a 230-volt service. This is this is a NEMA 14 colon 50, a 1450 plug, which has got three of these terminals. This is in the middle, right below this center ground, and behind this terminal is another terminal. So one, two, three, four. Four things that plug in. This guy right here is the size of my fist. I had that behind me in my little office studio thing here. Because I got this thing, which is 45 hours. I've got that right up to here. This plugs in there. There's a plug on the other end of this. This is about a foot long. This is 20 feet. So you need this doodad to plug into the socket. And then there's little green lights that light up on this. You know, when it's charging the car. And it charges with the 230 volt circuit. That's like a 50 amp circuit, which means it's putting out 32 amps with that 230 volts. So it's a six, they call it a 6 kW circuit. And that delivers about 25 miles of range, 25 miles worth of fuel in your tank, so to speak, aka the battery. So to try to swap some terms from the gas tank, you know, we'll call it a fuel tank. So we're not defining what kind of fuel energy it is. It happens to be electricity, electric energy. But, so, this setup, when plugged in, will deliver 25 miles worth of range into your tank. So 8 times 20, so if it's plugged in 8 hours, that'll give you, 8 quarters is 2 hours, 200 miles of range. So if you plugged in 9 hours worth, it'll give you up to 250 miles of range. When you charge the battery to 90%, which they recommend, they don't want you to do, a complete fill up unless you have to. Like if you're going on a trip, it's okay to fill it all the way up. But if you're just day to day, and I charge, like twice a week. When it gets down to under 40% in my fuel tank, in the battery. It's so odd to say battery when you're talking about a car. So we'll just say it's the fuel tank. A fuel, what kind of fuel? It's electric energy fuel. And everyone else uses gasoline powered fuel, and the big trucks use diesel, in their fuel tank. Anyway, so I'm using the word fuel tank so that people don't get all distracted with the fact that I'm driving an electric car and I have a big battery in there. And it's actually about 5,000 cells. That's a good bit larger than a AA battery. So you know what a AAA battery looks like. And then the bigger one is a AA battery. So think of this as just a single A battery, you know. And you have three sizes. Anyway, the lithium cells, they're calling the 2170, 21700 cell, which means that it's, where's my batteries? Oops. There it is. There's a battery. So in this battery, this is a new one. They call this the 4680 cell. So it's 46 millimeters in diameter. Okay. And 80 millimeters high. Now the cell that I have is 21 millimeters. Half this diameter. And this is 80 millimeters high. The other cell is 70 millimeters high. So it's, you know, that size right there, instead of this size. So this one, their engineers are saying, is 5 times more energy, 16% more range, and 6 times more power, you know, than a 2170 cell, I guess. Which, well, of course, it's bigger. I mean, that size cell is the size of a small tomato can, which I should have in here as a prop, but I don't. Okay. So right now I'm on 22.8.3, which, you know, what does these things mean? So there's a lot of other software versions that Tesla has pushed out there. You see the one with that's a slightly orange color. Seventeen percent of all the drivers of the Model Y have decided to participate in the full service driving beta program. I was in there for about 2 months in the beta, and it's alpha, you know. It's just, you know, I didn't like using it. You could turn it on and off, you know. You basically push down on the, you know, as those column things, bang, bang, and you just tap twice down on the right-hand column, do that, where the directional signals and all that, on the other side, you know. But on the right side, you know, it's push it down twice, bang, bang. And that engages the full self-driving computer. Well, I didn't like it. So, see, 17% of all the Model Y drivers are on this version software for the full self-driving. 17% as it relates to 40%. Let me just get my trusty calculator out here. Clear data. 17.3 divided by So 20, 40. Yeah, okay. Well, you got this 3% over here. Oops. 17.3 divided by 63.4. 63.4. Combining these two. 27%. So roughly 20. Okay, you got an 8% here too, so we got those. So let's say 25%. 25% of the Model Y drivers have activated the full self-driving capability. So you know, I can buy that software, you know, on the subscription service, which costs, you know, $200 a month. So for $200 a month, I'm gonna drive around with what I consider alpha software. No. The autopilot that's in the car, that's in this, see this 40% column, which is software 2022, eighth week in the year, and the third version of this software that was produced in the eighth week of 2022 is the third software version. So the autopilot, you know, works fine for, you know, keeping your car in your lane. And if you try to get out of your lane, it really pulls on the wheel. Now I just got a new, let's see, how do I show this to you? I can show it to you here. Here's my Tesla. So, you know, this is the app that actually is connected to my car, and it says I have 235 miles worth of, you know, range. Battery 77%. The fuel tank is 77% full, meaning 23% empty. So you can imagine, you know, the fuel gauge, you know, if you had one that was this way, that way. See, in the electronic car business, they just show you the miles, the actual miles that they've calculated that your fuel tank will take you before it gets down to 0 miles, or 0%. You know, I'm 77%, so I'm good. So, it says I have a software update. Now, I checked with other sources, and that's this update. So I'm gonna move from this column to this column. Apparently they're shifting everybody, all the Model Ys that are in here, they're gonna shift them over here. And then this column is gonna look like one of these, you know, 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 percenters. You know, people that are, you know, out of the country and the car's garaged, or they just don't want to update their firmware as much as I do. I'm always Johnny on the spot. And you can see, oops, from down below here, the bottom line says Jim W. Model Y, my phone number, version, and then 22.8.3. So that reads that right off the computer. That's right, you know, right behind the console, right in the middle of the car, behind the console, is the self-driving, or the you know, the computer for the car, which does autopilot and all this other stuff, and controls the power to the wheels, and you know, everything about the car is in this full self-driving capable computer. If I go down here and hit more details, let's see, what does this say? Maybe I don't have to. Let's go to controls. You can see. See, I'm running on 22.8.3. This is my VIN number and my odometer right here, 6,232 miles. That's the name of the program. See climate here? Nice thing about this thing, I can turn on the air conditioner from here just by doing that. You see this animation? Looks like a steam coming out of here. That's the vents. Now I can turn it off. Oops. Now it's off. It's all it's kind of amazing, isn't it? So here you see software update. Now this is on my iPad. I'm not doing it on my iPhone. I got my clock on the phone, so I'm just leaving that alone. Let's see, it's asking. It's saying here's software update coming. Here's my miles, my 77% business, and climate. I'm doing here so I can turn it on. 64 degrees. So air conditioning is blowing in my car right now. So you don't have an engine, so to speak, like in a regular gas car. You've got motors for the wheels, and we have a motor that, or an electric compressor, put that way. So it's blowing air conditioning right now in my car, and I can see the interior temperature is now 69 degrees and the exterior temperature is 82 degrees. The interior is 68, it'll drop almost a percent, now it's 67. See, and of course there's no sense in spending fuel to air condition a car that I'm not in. And actually, no one's in. The car's just sitting there in the garage. So now it says climate, interior, 69 degrees. Now that'll start coming up, you know, as the, because the air conditioner is not running. See, 70, now 71, you know, 72. And then it'll end up and 80, just like the exterior temperature is. Assuming it's 80 degrees outside. Actually, I don't know. Something like that. Okay, so I can basically disconnect from the Tesla app. It's running in the background on my phone. See, the phone is your key. This app, this this is your key. Now, I don't have this iPad set up. He set up his phone key. You know, have your key card ready. And that's a card. Looks like a credit card that I have in my wallet. This is the Tesla key card. Tesla? I got my name and address on it. And this gives you like very faint directions on how to use. You just tap the card on the column between the front and rear windows. Right on the outside of the car. You tap the car there, and that unlocks the car. That's if batteries in your phone and all that kind of stuff are dead and whatever. You know, you can use that to unlock the car. But otherwise, you use the app in your phone, which is always running. In the background here, that app is running on my phone. Because your phone is your key. I remember the guy saying that. He used exactly those words. Your phone is your key. Okay. I remember that. So, it's amazing. So I can have my car parked out in a parking lot, windows up, locked. It's 84 degrees outside. I'm making this up. 84 degrees outside. And and I can see the interior temperature of the car. See right there where it says climate. Anyway, where it says climate, now it says 85 degrees. Now it's in the garage, so there's no sun hitting it. So, you know, that's basically equilibrium with the outside temperature. But if I was out in the parking lot in the sun, that would climb to 105 and maybe 110 degrees in your car. Well, the average fella would finish with his luncheon meeting and then walk back to his car and open the door and whoosh, you know, you get blasted with all this heat. And of course the seat cushions are 120, the top of the steering wheel is 190, you know, whatever, because you can't hold the steering wheel, so it's so hot. But with the Tesla, when I'm signing the bill, assuming I sign a bill, or whenever bill signing is occurring, I'll go to the Tesla app, and I'll hit climate. And I'll hit on, and that turns the air conditioner on for me. Basically on about 75% of full blast. So it's gonna cool that sucker down. And by the time you finish, you know, dilly-dallying with the bill or whatever you're doing, or someone's taking you to lunch, and when they're finished diddling, I've already got my air conditioner running, and then you stand up and you shake hands, give a hug, whoever you have lunch with, and then you gently walk out the front door, and then you know, that person goes that way and you go this way to go get your car in the parking lot. And by the time you get to the car, it's 66 degrees. It's pretty much, what I have in here, it's set at 64. If I turn it down to 63, it automatically turns it on. Whoops, 63, I'm gonna turn it back off again. So right now the interior of the car is 85. And the exterior of the car is 82. So that's the temperature in the garage. Yeah, it's a garage for our building. It's on the fourth floor. The fourth, number four in the elevator button. Which is like floor six, I think, actually in the garage. So six in the garage is number four in the elevator button. That's all I want to know. So that's a pretty cool feature. It's all standard, you know. The only thing you can do when you go to the Tesla site, which I think if I push this one, it goes to, there you go, Model 3. Let's go to Model Y. Let's order one now. Okay, I'll do it over here so you can see it. Custom order. All right. We want purchase price. Pull this up. What is this, Model 3? Bingo, there we go. There's Model Y. We want purchase price. Purchase price. They say 318 miles of range. There we go. 318. Range. Top speed of 135 miles an hour. I want the performance. It costs $5,000 more, but you get better wheels, which you'd have to pay $2,000 for. So why pay $2,000 for that when it's included in the performance? Plus you get special brakes. And there are motors inside that are better motors. Oops, that's what it looks like. I'm not ready for that part. Okay, so we want white paint, which is included. These wheels, which are really nice wheels. Uber turbine wheels, they go up. Okay. Tow hitch. Add that. Just in case we want to tow something. The interior. We want white. They charge you an extra $1,000 for a white interior. The white interior is really quite nice. really, it brightens up the car so much. You know, you feel like you're in a space capsule. A space capsule. Instead of a dark black car interior. Which I have had for 45 years of driving, or maybe a few more years, but I don't wanna tell you how many more years. Okay, feature details. So, glass roof. Center display. It's a big 15-inch diagonal display. You can put your phones. You see, you have your phones, place them right in there, and it's got the wireless charging going on with your modern iPhone. See, wireless charging. And there's also two USB ports inside this, underneath this, what do you call it, armrest. And there are also two inside here. All vegan interior. Meaning it's not leather, not from an animal, at least not one with four legs. Up to seven seats, we don't want seven seats, we just have the standard five seats. Three in the back, and two in the front. Here's your advanced climate control, and it is quite advanced, actually. It has a HEPA filtration system, so it removes all those kinds of particles. It has, with this visual display, you can put your fingers on the display and move it up and move it down, and this flow of air will move up and move down. You move it over this way, and then move it over to the side. This guy can do the same thing independently. So, everything's touch control. There aren't any knobs. All right, audio media. Premium 13 speakers. One subwoofer. Two amplifiers. And immersive sound. And I can tell you, the music and media over Bluetooth, so I can have music in my phone and it connects directly into the car with Bluetooth. You don't have to do anything. There's also in the glove box, there's 128 gigabyte portable storage. My light's just brightened up. Let there be light, and there is light. Okay, how we doing? Yeah. All right, so comfort. And power adjustable front seats. Heated front and rear seats. Heated steering wheel. You know, you don't want to try to drive on a steering wheel that's 27 degrees. So they heat them up for you. A HEPA air filtration system with genuine HEPA filters. Tinted glass roof. The whole roof is glass. You look back this way and it just keeps on going. People in the back seat get quite a panoramic view of glass top. You know, and the windshield in the front, and independent flat fold rear seats. So you can push them all the way back, and those people can go to sleep. LED fog lamps, power folding, auto dimming, heated side mirrors, custom drive profiles for each. or, you know, her husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever. You can set up your profile and it saves it. So then if the little woman comes out, her profiles are separately saved. You can save any number of them. Live traffic visualization. This is the premium connectivity 3-day complimentary. You sign up for that and it costs you $10 a month. Live traffic visualization. Satellite view maps, which I use all the time. Video streaming allows access to content from Netflix, Hulu, YouTube, Twitter, and more. Karaoke, if you you want to juke around while you're waiting for your fuel tank. Music streaming, internet browser. Okay, that's that. See, here's the full self-driving. You want to buy it? Cost you $12,000. You click that thing, and all of a sudden, price of the car goes up $12,000. I think we'll pass on that. We'll do the subscription service at $200 a month. So that's like, you know, $200 a month, that's like 3 years or so to pay off the $12K. Yeah. A wall connector. A mobile connector. $200. If I'm lucky enough to drive another one of these, I'm going to take my connector that I have in the trunk of the car, and I'm going to retain it and transfer it to the trunk of the new car when I get the white car with the white interior. If, assuming, you know, I survive long enough to be able to do that. Continue to payment. So that's it. That's all the choices you get. You know, black, white, red, blue. Black and white interior, that's it, baby. You know, he doesn't. American cars, they have all kinds of different shades. Not Tesla. You got 2 colors of interior and you got 4 colors of paint. That's it. If you want the red, it costs you like $2,500. The white, they're the wheels. Very nice wheels. So the vehicle is $70,000, $1,200 for documentation and transportation. So other fees, $250 for, I don't know what that is. That's other fee. Now you got to write a check for $250 to order this car. It's non-refundable. You can buy the car with a credit card or pay with Apple Pay. That's quite an Apple Pay. Or let's do lease. So let's customize the payment. That's interesting to see that. See, right now it's $4,500 down, and then 36 monthly payments, assuming you're going to drive 10,000 miles or less, includes documentation, tax, and debt, about $867 a month with $4,500 down. Let's go back to lease and let's make this. There we go, $500 down. And with $500 down, the 36 month, you only got 36 month lease. 10,000 miles. So with $500 down, then the due at signing is $2,183. you know, your transportation fees and all that business. And then it's $988 a month, which includes the sales tax on the lease, which is the way Florida works. If it was a car loan, it's 45, 72 a month, that's as long as it goes, it'd be $1,000 a month, and $4,500 down, that's your 3% interest rate lease. I go back to my lease. I'd rather turn that sucker in every 3 years. And that way you get a new car every 3 years with all the, you know, what all the stuff, show details. That's the name of the game there. $71,500. And that's with performance. That's not with all the goodies, but that's just about all the goodies. We didn't get red paint. That would have added $1,500 more. I guess they're gonna run that through the painter a few times. I don't know what the deal is, but if you got a red one, charge, I think, $2,500 more. Show details. We don't get California. You know this. With the cash price. Vehicle price, $70,000. That's it, $70,000. And then you got $1,400 worth of baloney. So it's 70,000. Yep. It's gone up about 3,000 since we got, or 2,500, or maybe it's 2,000. About 2,000 in the year. Next month we will have the car 1 year. Anyway, so that's an interesting little, you know, experiment with leasing a car. And you push the button and it tells you when it's going to be delivered. We can't quite push that button because, let's see, does it tell us? Oh yeah, estimated delivery, June, July, or August. So if we get it today, we do it today, which is, this is May, for all intents and purposes. Alright, we got that. Which is basically long range, better motors. See, the EPA is 318. With the performance, it's 303, but you can go 155 miles an hour. 0 to 60 in 3.5 seconds. 0 to 60 in 4.8 seconds. Believe me, this is, I have this one, it's like a rocket ship. you hit the accelerator pedal and you accelerate, and everybody else you see in your rear view mirror. It's really, it's fun to do that every so well. And you use a rocket ahead up to 50 miles an hour, you know. So you go to 0 to 50 in 3 seconds, you know. And everybody is like, you know, 1,000 feet behind you. It's amazing. Well, let's do the red paint and see what happens to the price. doesn't work yet. All right, continue the payment. See, now the price of the car is $72.5. So that's $2,500 more because of the paint. Edit the design. See, or 2,000 more. The white paint is included. It's included. Got the wheels, got the tow hitch. We had that. The interior, that's like, they get you $1,000 for. See, black interior, no good. Black and white, $1,000 added. I gotta do it. That's what I want. I do not want that. I do not want any of that. Continue to the payment. June, July, August, somewhere in there. See, the premium cars, they, you know, if you go cheap on the car, you don't have to wait 6 months for the car. But if you get, you know, basically the premium features, car price $70,000, see, $70,000, you know, plus $10, and the rest of it is, you know, destination dock stamp fee and all this other crap, and the order fee is $250. Okay, why not get you for an order fee? What are you gonna say? No. Due today, $250. So you basically paying for the order fee up front, and you don't get that back. I agree to buy the car. And they're gonna lease, they're gonna deliver it to you. And this car, as we have it configured, oh no, I didn't customize this. We gotta customize this. Let's be crazy. $250. $250 down. That's it. Please. Alright. So, back out of that. So now my lease payment is $996. Hey, you. Alright, so we've done a few interesting things here tonight. And Epidemius is still playing. We're back to everything looks pretty good. Full screen mode on my computer, which you could probably see from this function F, full screen, function F, and watch the screen. There you go. I get this purple stuff here, and let's see, so this is that screen. It's good there. So I'm going to wrap it up. So I wish you all a good rest of the day and a good weekend. And we'll, God, I may pick up on you tomorrow, maybe. Maybe tomorrow. If not, Monday. So.